Just because Mark Zuckerberg and Bill Gates dropped out of school doesn't mean you have to. I understand balancing school and startup can be tricky, but it's still possible. You don't have to drop out of school to be successful. The thing is, if you don't sacrifice for your dream, then your dream becomes your sacrifice. Stick with me to the end of this video to discover how to start a business while in school.
Skill Faculty, we are on the side of skill.
If you're just meeting me for the first time, my name is Flora. Here in this channel, my passion is sharing everything related to business and personal development skills with you at every slightest opportunity. Subscription to this channel is also very simple. Just click on the subscription button below and also turn on the notification bell so you'll be the first to know once you upload a video. First, as an undergraduate, you have to put this at the back of your mind that it's very easy to spend money, but it's a lot harder to make it. Starting a business while you're in school is not just buying and selling. A great company and a career can be built while you're in school. It all depends on how willing you are to do the right thing. So if you're about to get into university or already enrolled, the following guideline will help you get a head start on. The first one is choose the right course. Yes, once you choose a course related to your field, you're on the right track. It makes it easier for you to practicalize what you'll be learning. That is, if you're ready to get into school or if you're already in it. It will be best to choose your type of business based on your course of study. In that case, it makes it easier to practice post-graduation and build a reputable brand for yourself. Go to school with a purpose to avoid having to wallow in no direction after school. You might be thinking it's not possible, but I bet you it is. There are so many undergraduates doing exploits on social media, especially on YouTube. If your interest is in doing business, you might consider studying courses like economics, business management and administration, computer science, and even industrial engineering, and so on. So the second tip I have for you on how to start a side hustle while in school is come up with an idea. The best way to do this is to find a problem. Finding a problem is the key ingredient to starting any business. What course are you studying? What are the problems facing it? Or you might start with yourself. What are your hobbies? That's what you enjoy doing. There are tons of challenges that these hobbies are facing that is waiting for your business idea. Just find a problem. It doesn't matter if you're the one facing it or someone around you. What matters is you identifying the problem and getting a solution. Okay? So let's get to the third tips I have for you if you want to start a career while you're still in school. Is to prioritize. Most activities in school are important, but you have to choose wisely. Starting a business while in school technically means you're steps ahead of most of your mates. It means you now have a direction. At the same time, it means you can't get involved in all the unnecessary activities. First, determine your short-term career goals and long-term career goals and how school fits into them. Decide when to sacrifice study time versus business opportunity. Each situation depends on the urgency of the deadlines. But setting priorities can help you clear your mind for which goal to focus on at any given period, bearing in mind that you will not drop out. So let's get to the fourth thing, commit to personal development. You know, that's what this channel is all about. Personal development, that's just it. Starting your own business requires a lot of strategic planning and a wealth of knowledge. Before you undertake a risk venture and invest in something new, take the responsibility of mastering your area of interest. Study those who are already in the field, that is your potential competitors, what they are doing right now, and most importantly, what they are not doing right. Then think of how you can do better. If you're ready to take your ideas out there and actually develop a solid business out of it, make sure you have the best educational background to prepare you for your exciting new venture. Most importantly, develop integrity as a skill. It will boost your recommendation from your schoolmates in the future. And the fifth point here is develop your time management skill. Now that you've chosen this path, you have to learn to balance your time to have a balanced student life. Your weekends and your holidays are to be put into proper perspective. When you develop your time management skill, activities like partying should not be avoided totally. The time spent will be used for socializing or as a reward when you achieve a goal. The saying, "There is time for everything," should apply to your everyday life. Be more calculated about your activities, both during school section and off section. Don't follow crowd. You're already exceptional by taking the first step, by deciding that. So don't follow crowd, because you're already positioning yourself for success. Not everyone is positioned for that, so be careful, okay? The sixth point I have for you here, if you want to develop a career while you're still in school, is networking. School offers a lot of free time. Take advantage of that and connect with other students. Make sure to let them know that this is what you are doing and you intend to continue after school. Believe me, you'll be surprised when you'll be called upon years later. Most of your mates have great potential that will be of great benefit to your company in the nearest future. They might know someone that knows someone that knows someone that knows someone that knows the president. Bear that in mind and don't leave any opportunity untapped. Exchange contacts. social media handles and so on. Be deliberate about your relationship building skills. You will thank me later. You can't afford to socialize like others. Be intentional about it. Don't burn bridges. Make sure you keep good relationship. It goes beyond your classmates. You might also consider pitching the idea of collaboration with the ones that has something to offer and validate your business idea. Then the seventh one, don't be in a hurry. The fact that you want to start a business does not mean you're making profits the next morning. Business has its principles. You need time to learn and unlearn. Remember, you're still a student. You don't expect to have the same result with someone who has more time than you. You have to get past that youthful desire of sharp and face reality. Else, you risk dropping out or losing interest. Give yourself time to strategize and practice, then go one step at a time. When you look back, you'll be amazed on how far you have come. Then the eighth one is get a mentor. As a student, most people are generally willing to help you. They don't see you as a competition at this stage. Mentors are there to offer advice, coaching and opportunities to connect with real businesses. Take advantage of that. It has never been easier to have a mentor than it is right now with the era of technology. Social media will give you access to so many role models, but you have to be wise with your choice. I cannot overemphasize that. Let me give you a simple trick. How to do that? For example, you're a law student studying criminal law. Go to social media, Twitter, YouTube, and so on. Follow those already practicing criminal law with a proven track record of success. Study them, replicate them as much as you can, bearing in mind that success is a journey. And if you're part of Skill Faculty community, you already know that here we don't blow, we grow. The ninth point on how to start a business while you're still in school is to be visionary. You cannot excel in business if you don't have a sense of direction. Vision means having a much larger picture of your business or your life than simply setting and reaching short-term goals and tackling problems as they come. Visions are powerful, but leaving it as it is will not yield any results. Be deliberate, break it down to goals, and build a system to achieve that. Create a very clever strategy. Vision will justify you to say no to unhealthy relationships and activities in school. Develop a positive mindset. Yes. Remember, as a man thinketh in his mind, so he is. If you think you're not going to succeed, I can't help you. No matter how long I talk here, I can't help you. I mean, no one can either. Be intent about what you allow to stay long on your mind. Thoughts are powerful. Building a business or career is not easy. You need a positive mindset to scale through. Connect your mind to positivity. Abstain from negative thoughts. And in no time, you'll see yourself evolve. The last but not the least, the 11th one, stay consistent. Try not to confuse your potential clients. It's okay to have different income, but not at this stage. Focus on one at a time. Don't sell clothes today, and when it finishes, instead of restocking clothes, you start selling dry fish, or you intend to already practicing criminal law. You want to sell wigs and bleaching cream on social media as a side hustle. Don't get me wrong, there's nothing wrong with selling those. Except that you're most likely going to lose your purpose in school and in life general in the name of passion. Listen, let me tell you something. Passion is associated with emotion, meaning that you can develop it.
Skill Faculty is geared towards teaching, promoting and empowering you with the skills needed to become a better version of yourself in all ramifications. Skill Faculty, we are on the side of skill.